Hello, all you vapors out there, and welcome back to GS Vapor Reviews here at
Good Smoke.
And I'm going to try and do it as quick as possible today. I'm not going to be doing a tutorial. I'm not going to be doing my putting liquid in and showing you how they vape and things like that. I'm going to go through them because there is three to do on this video, and I haven't got loads of time to do them. So I'm going to read out what obviously the instructions, what they're capable of, what coils are in there, how you work them, blah blah blah, things like that, and then. Obviously, we'll leave that. All you're going to have to do is put your liquid in, but I know they are fucking... pardon my language. I know they are amazing. Absolutely amazing. So what we'll do, we'll go down below, and then we'll have a look at everything, and then we'll see how they work. Right then, guys. So, I've got three Innocon products to show you. So, the first one is this here. Beautiful. So this is, if I can pronounce it, where is it? The Endura T18-2. Okay, looks beautiful. So this is a pretty decent size on it as well. It's quite large. This reminds me like the Freemax kit, the 25, I think it was. Anyways, I'll show you this in a second. I'll go down, I'll open the box and just show you what's inside. So on the back, it says what it includes. So there's the battery is 1300 megahertz, comes with the tank, two coils, one magnetic cap, spare drip tip, spare O-rings, micro USB, quick starter guide, and the user packet, which I'll show you now. So nice little pulley string. So this is where that would be, like that, be all ready inside for you. So if we take this out now, actually I'll show you this side quickly first. So it shows you every bit. I like the way they've designed this as well. Do you know what I mean? You literally open it, it's like a little book, and you've already got some of the stuff here. So it shows you, for example, after vaping, the LED light blinks twice to show remaining battery. So full, it'll be full, half, you lose one, recharge. It's basically when it's low and you need to recharge, it'll be one. Shows you how to refill the tank here. Turn top caps fill to open. I'll show you all that afterwards. Close, not over tight. Wait 5 minutes before vaping to prime new coil. Now, you can change this. You don't have to wait 5 minutes. If you take the coil out and prime it yourself, then fill it up, you just gotta wait about 30 seconds a minute. Replacement coil if burned, keep tank filled over 1/3 to maximize coil life. So basically what people tend to do is use the whole liquid up in the tank, and that way then the top starts drying out before the bottom, so the top will start burning. So always keep it, you know, up to maybe just that bottom line or just in between the two there. And that way you can maximize it out. So this is all the stuff that comes up to. And then some support things there. Adjust wattage, click 3 times to turn power off, hold button, and it'll LED lights will, the LED wattage indicator cycle. So it goes on a scale of 10.5 watts, 12, and 13.5. So basically hold the power button down once it's turned off. So I'll show you quickly how to do that. So if I take the atomizer off, because I don't want to wreck the atomizer because it's new. So, is this turned off? It is turned off. So, if I hold the power button, that'll be on the low, that'll be on 10.5. No, it's our lights the other way. So that's medium, high, low, medium, high. Sorry, I had a customer in. So, where was I? I think I was doing the battery. So I showed you the battery is on high. We put it back on. I will show you something else as well. The airway. So most things, it looks like it normally has an airway on the bottom, which is normally one hole or two holes on either side. This one, if I can move that out of the way. This one, basically what it does is, the airway comes through. Is it gonna focus? I think I took it off autofocus and that's why. There's your airway. Okay, so there's the airway by there on the either side. So what happens is it goes into this and gets pulled out them holes at the top, and then you can adjust it on the machine, which I kind of like, because even if you put something else on it, you've got a dual airway then as well. So you can close this if you just want to use the airway on the atomizer, or just use this one, which is pretty good. I like that. Is it turned off? Perfect. So let's have a look at the coil. So you've got a magnetic cap, so nothing goes into it, which I like. That's very good. You drip tip, and it comes. I was showing you the box, wasn't I? That's where it was. We'll go to the box first, and I'll get back to that because there's things. In the box you have your charger, your warning safety. So you have them guys, then you have a spare coil in here. So you get two coils with it, and they're both different. I think one, so it said on the back, one of them is, the one that's inside this, I think is, no, they're both the same. They're both 1.5 coils inside this. It's one of the other machines I'm thinking of. Both 1.5, TPD ready. And there's the coils. So you get a spare one with it, really long coils. Anyways, you get that, you get your warranty card, your battery care card, if I can get that out of the box, which I don't think is going to want to come out. So it always says to look at this. So always keep it with 10% maximum battery lifespan. So otherwise, if you leave it down, it'll just disintegrate. Don't leave charging for external periods of time. Stop charging when battery is full. Vaping while charging must be used with 10% battery. So basically, if you've got it on charge, plugged in something, and it's not 10% or over, don't do it. And then just read all this as well. What's that say there? Check with your airline before flying with your vaporizer. Don't worry about that. You're not going to use it on there anyway. And then that's your quick setup guide, which will just show you how to set it up. So I'll refill the tank, your chargers. Basically, everything that's on the inside is on this as well. Okay, so that's that. We'll put that back in. So we've still got two more products to go through. So put that away. So then you've got your tank. I took the top cap off. You can see the coil on the inside there. So we'll unscrew this. So then to take the coil out, you just pull and the coil comes out. Pretty simple. Sorry guys, another customer. It's getting one of them days. No customers before and now there's loads. So anyway, your coil there, you pop it back in like so, and it's got a little catch by there so you can put it in properly. If I can get it set in, there's it set. And I don't think it's gonna come off because it's quite tight. But that top part, there you go. Top part screws off so you can refill your juice. Not inside, around it. Okay, never put it inside unless you're just priming the coil, just drop a few drops inside. That's it, it's about two milligrams? No, 2.5 milliliters or 2 milliliters TPD capacity. Okay, so that's that. So we'll put the tip back on, magnetic, and we'll put it back together. So that is that, guys. I will go through all the prices of all of them at the end, but beautiful, absolutely beautiful. It says there's a... Oh, there you go. For your cat. That's quite handy. I only just cut that off the side of my eyes. Anyways, three times turn it on, three times turn it off. When you're not using it, put that there, use away, and cap back on. That's pretty, I like that. I like that very much. So that is that one, guys. That was the Endura T18 2. So that's that one. So there's one. Whew. Let's go for the second one. Now this is a kit. This is the Zenith, I think it's called. The Chroma A Zenith by Inokin. So they've got a new coil in it. The Plexus coil lasts much longer. And obviously you can get them off the shops, but we do stock the coils for these. On the back then, it says it includes the kit. Well, the kit, yeah. The tank. It's got a 0.5 coil installed, but it also then comes with a Knethel coil that ranges at 1.6 for the higher vapors. Your charger, your spare O-rings, extra drip tip, user pack, and then it comes with all your little things there. Okay, so we'll open that up. So inside, you will find obviously your mod, but I have got it out here at the moment, so we'll have a look at that in a minute. Inside the box then, it comes with your, I think this is like a thank you card, and obviously about the coils. What it says recommends for the wattages and things like that, which is pretty nice. And then we created this product for those who enjoy mouth-to-lung style vaping, as well as those who look to transition to vaping with ease. Hope you enjoy this as much as we do, thank you. So obviously then it's signed and everything, I really like that. That's a nice little thank you card. So. There's your other coil by there. This is a 1.6 coil. So this will be the other one that it came with. A spare drip tip by there. Which that was in there, but obviously there was two in. I had to set it up yesterday to show people. So obviously it's only got the one in the case. So we'll close that back up. is one side, and then this is your accessory side, which just slides out like this. And inside you will find, if I don't drop them everywhere, so you get your charger, your band, protection band, which I like. Not many people dish these out with their kits. Some spare O-rings. This is your user manual, isn't it? Quick start guide. So then it tells you how it's all set up. Indicator volt, micro charging, on and off. Your Zenith coil airflow. So it's 4mm capacity and 2mm TPD ready. Top filling, which is up the top, which I can show you there. If I can find how to open it. So that's closed. And then you hold it and it'll spin around there. Which is pretty cool. No hassle. Your drip tip. So it's a Durham wide bore tip. It says here to fill it up and how to change everything and blah, blah, blah. Shows you your coils. Your coil type, so the settings it has, so it does have your coil type, so you can do same nichrome, titanium, stainless steel, and wattage. There you can also, it shows you what's on the wattage menu, so your battery life, your puff time, your wattage, volts, and resistant. You got temperature control on there as well, so you got your resistance wire, you got your wattage that it would be, and temperature control, it either comes in Celsius or Fahrenheit. Your LED indicators of your battery life. So it'll be full green, half battery will be yellow, and red will be low. Settings, so obviously hold the Bose to precise reading resistance, volt, and puffs. Just press them for that. Hold them for flip display orientation, so you can flip which side it's on. Hold these for mode selection, and hold these ones here to just ramp up wattage in temperature control mode. Then you've got your supports by there. So let's put that back in and we'll have a look. This is an internal battery, guys. It's not an external where you can change your batteries. This is a built-in battery. I cannot tell you what the megahertz is because it never came up on the box or the information, so I'm not too sure on that. But I'm pretty sure it will last you a while depending on what mode you're using it on, what wattage, and things like that. If you're not ramping the wattage up loads and you're not using a really low coil or you're changing the tanks on there, it should last quite a while. So we'll close that up and put that back in there. So this is the red one that I've got here to show you. So this is it, guys. So it's quite nice, quite small, which I like. It reminds me of the Pico. Got a bit of weight to it. The tank seems a lot heavier than the mod, to be honest, but we'll take that off and we'll show you this. So it is always on, guys. It has a standby mode but not a complete turn off mode, whereas some have a standby mode, like you lock it. This is always on. I need a vapor after all this. Right, so as you click it, it says it's off, and it's three times turn it on. 1, 2, 3. Starts up with the Inokun logo. No coil on there, no voltage. It's a maximum of 75 watts, guys. Check atomizer, because I've got no atomizer on there. But it goes, you hold it, flashes, and then you can turn it down. See what I mean? Perfect. So then, like we said, you can flip it and do other things with it if you hold the buttons. So Fahrenheit. So this is basically, I'm changing the settings. If it wants to come back now. Oh, am I going to be able to get it off this now? There you go. And that reverses it. Perfect. And then you hold the other ones for different settings like I showed you in the book. But yeah, fire. So it just keeps saying check atomizer. I've not got an atomizer handy that I can put on there quickly. But yeah, this is very nice. So this is really smooth. This seems just like a paint job on there. So that might rub off after a while, but don't have to worry. USB charger, positive, up, down, on and off. This is nice, so this is your grip, it's quite nice, and your top, so this is where your tank will go, onto there. I'll show you the tank in a second. But yeah, really nice, guys. It's got some really nice settings on there, like I showed you. It's obviously got nichrome, stainless steel, temperature control, things like that on there, so you can do it how you want. So let's pop that there for a second. This will be your tank. So we'll unscrew it. So you unscrew the bottom to get to your coil. Same type of thing as the other one. Slide out. Look at that. Very nice. So this is the Knethel. Recommends to run at 14 to 19 watts. It's a Z coil. Is it, what's it say there? A Z coil at 0.5 ohms. Perfect. So there is, I like that. That's quite nice. Would be nice if we see smooth, but that's all right. So you pop it back in the way it's supposed to and it'll clip there. And you screw it back in. So you're not messing about, guys, like trying to refill it. So you've got to take your coil out, refill it. Like some of the other ones, like the Just Fog P16, you've got to take the tank off to change the coil and to fill it up. It's not nice. This here, so like I showed you before, you screw the top and it's got it on there as well. So you screw that part and it opens and closes. So you're not going to mess about. And obviously it comes with the band as well to put over the glass, so you're not going to smash it. So your tip by here fits in there. You can obviously change the tips if you want. That's quite a thin hole on there. I would like to see a little bit of a bigger hole, but that's quite kind of screwed up. That's really thin on there. But it is a mouth-to-lung piece anyway. I'm more of a straight-to-lung. But that's it, guys. Not much you can say about them. It's a nice little kit. It's more of a starter kit for people who want a bigger mod that don't want the pen-type ones like I just showed you. If it wants to roll away, it's going to go in. Screw that on there. And that would be your kit. So now it'll probably read the coil on there. Same coil, reading wattages, and then it'll show you as you're using it. I want to say that after I want to turn it off. There you go, so it's turned off now. Perfect, so that was the, was that? That weren't the Endura, that was a Caroma, I think. Yeah, Caroma A Zenith. So Zenith is obviously this. So that's that one, guys. So we'll put that one to a side. And now last but not least, we have this one. So this is the Proton mod by Inicon. This one you can change the batteries. It says there how to put them in. So A battery, B battery, positive side up, negative side down. No, negative side up, positive side up. Click, I like the click. I like these ones, I've said in a few videos, I like this. I don't like the one with the switches because they can just get caught. That's got a nice little click onto it and it's not gonna come off even though that goes like that. It'll change when the batteries are in there, which I'll put two in there quickly now. So you can see there, so positive side down. Negative side down. Inicon. So you have your button there. So three times turn it on, which is a side click. One, two, three. Starts up. This is just like a little dandy side, so they've matched the other side up there, but this is your fire button. 80 watts. It does go all the way up to 235 watts. We'll go through the box here a sec. So let's have a look. So it says inside you get your Proton, micro USB charging cable, user pack, your QR card, warranty card, booklet, and warning. I'm not going to open it up, guys, because it's, well, yeah, well, just I'll quickly show you. So that's what's in there. And your innovation inside would be your mod. Quickly show that. So just basically that's all that comes with it. So it is because it's just a mod. It's not going to come with all the little accessories and everything like that, guys. So not much to go through on that one. So look, so we're saying check atomizer because there's no atomizer on there. But you can up the wattage quite rampant. That's pretty quick. I like that. Then so obviously chain check atomizer. I think you hold the middle down. Am I wrong on that? One, two. The menu, how do I get the menu up? So it does, as it has other features. Just click that there. Does it maybe hold them two down? I haven't even looked at the instructions on it. I think we might have to. Quickly. So I'm going to up the accessories on this. So. There you go. So, side power pan and exit menu. So, 1.45 inch full colour screen. Joystick menu selection up, down, left and right, micro USB and two 18650 batteries, which is the only ones it will hold on there. So have a look. So that's for a tank, which is not included, but that's the tank it comes with. Here we go. Firing panel, click three times to turn it off. Click this three times, one, two, three. There you go. So you got your coil, temperature control mode, your curve bypass settings. So your vape cutoff, so that's basically how long you're vaping it for, and it cuts off after a few seconds if you're going over. I have mine set at 7 on mine. Settings again, so you got your screen, so it dims out, timeout, brightness, go back. Temperature control in Fahrenheit, your colour, puff count, firmware, which I haven't got to worry about. So your wattage increase, and that's all for your wattage, you can do it either side. That's for your preheats and everything like that. You got a vape lock and vape unlock, and you got, if you hold that, it's your coil resistance, battery voltage, and puff counter, it will show you. So if you hold them two at the same time, it tells you then what your batteries are, your coil, and how many puffs you've had, which is, I like that, that's really nice. I really do like that, that's pretty handy, because I haven't seen many come out with this. So, your vape lock is, you hold them two down and you go left, like that. Have to hold them both, otherwise it will not work. I've just turned it off. Anyway, that's fine, not a problem. It comes with all of your, like, you can adjust your colors there, temperature control, wattage mode there, and it'll tell you what everything is. The battery life will come up, obviously full, medium, low. Coils, in them coils is wattage, stainless steel and nichrome, it won't do any others. Custom temperature control materials, custom output, output battery voltage and wattage only. That's fine. Joystick to fire and panel to exit and things like that. So I've showed you everything on there, guys. It's pretty simple. It's not hard once you've read that. I mean, like, that's a quick one. So if you've got more time, you can sit there and read through the whole thing. I think there is an instruction manual on the inside that tells you everything, but you don't really need to know. Right then, guys. So that's it, that's that one. Pretty nifty, quite small as well, fits in your hand. It's about the same size as my switcher. So mine's just a little bit longer. That's all. But, nice little piece of kit, guys. So I'll take them batteries out. So that's that one. So guys, we will go back up top now and we will have a look at the prices and what's gonna be going on. Guys, I'm sorry that was a bit rushed, but there's three products to go through. I'm not doing a tutorial as in how it vapes and everything, so that'll be cut out a little bit as well, because they are brand new. I don't want to ruin another coil and I don't want to set them up, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, thing is, because we don't have these sent into us for the purpose of the review, I don't have a spare one to use, so it's just my own time that I do it all. Anyways, prices, guys. So this one right here will set you back €34. Now, €34 is not bad, because I know that the free max resell is 22. Now, that battery is half the battery of this. Doesn't come with neat little stuff like the magnet. Doesn't come with that. Doesn't come with the top cap. Right, the tanks are all right, they're not the best. This is bigger. So yeah, pretty nice. I do like that. I do like the airflows and everything on that as well. Let a bike go past. It's a really neat little stick, guys. Very nice. 34. So then we'll go to the Proton mod. Battery's not included, remember. Anyway, this one will set you back €63. Now, that's not bad for a mod that's new. Okay? So I know some mods that I've got in the store now are up to 70, 80, 90, and they go all the way up to 200 and €300. Okay? So this is nice. For the basic one, for basics, it's good. So someone who just wants a little mod, very nice. 63, guys. I will say on it, I do like the colouring on this. It still has the same that they've all done apart from the stick. It's got a little grip as a, that there as, what would you call it? Like a texture of it. Like bumpy, so it helps you grip it. Very nice. I like the little firing button because they made it different to the side panel. Very nice. And the little joystick. I like joysticks. They're pretty good on that. Anyways. That one will set you back €63, guys. Very nice. Then we'll get to the kit. So this was, I'm forgetting the name. This was the Coroma kit with the Zenith. Oh, I said that right. Zenith tank. This one is only €1 different than the mod, guys. This is €64. This is obviously an integrated, the battery's already in there. Comes with a tank, €64. You can't go wrong for a starter kit. Mod, guys. Mouth to lung as well, you can change obviously your airways as well on there. It's gonna like tight. It's a full blast. There's five on there, guys. But yeah, pretty nice. Comes with everything that's. Guys, you can't go too. I can't go in too much, and I can't up them, and I can't say they're amazing because they are basic things. These are the kind of the starters. Then two are like the starter kits. And then this one is just for someone that you could put a mouth to lung piece on there if you're rebuilding. You can also put a different tank. You can put a mouth to lung tank on there. That's just a normal coil. But this is for people who are off the starter kits and want to up a little bit more. But yeah, guys, so you got 34, 34, 63, 64. Can't go wrong with the prices, guys. They're all basic, they are all nice, they're all good, they're all. These are going to be our new starter kits that we're going to be recommending to people. Obviously, I still have other things in here, but I'm still thinking these are pretty decent little things. Anyway, guys, that is all from me. As you can see, I've got a few Christmas stuff up. The whole shop's ready for Christmas now, because it's not long. So I hope you're all getting nice Christmas presents, if I haven't done a review by then. I hope you all have a good Christmas. I would say pop in. We probably will be doing something for Christmas in here, but pop into the store to keep up to date with things, or just keep on to my YouTube channel. Subscribe, like, comment. Make sure you get onto the other channel, which is the Good Smoke Vape Shop channel. Subscribe to them. There'll be icons popping up in a minute, so you can click onto those. Once they're up, click onto them, subscribe, like, comment. Let me know, guys, what you're using as usual, what liquids, what things, and I wanna try to get to know all of my viewers. That way, one day, maybe we can all do a live stream together or do something. Anyway, guys, that is it from me. You've had 3 reviews in 1. I am tired. I'm going for a coffee. I hope you all have a great day and you enjoy yourselves. Keep vaping on, guys. Ciao for now.